I woke up and with the words, show them how to fly without falling. And I couldn't get past that. I tried to do some other sermons and tried to get some different scriptures, and I actually got frustrated. Joey will tell you, I just got a little bit frustrated, and I had to go back to this and had to figure out what God was saying about it. And I began to look at the birds. That's what he sent me to, Matthew 6:25 and 26. And as I began to search the scriptures, I found that scriptures had lots of about birds in there, that there was 19 different kinds that I found that was mentioned in the Bible. And then there was 39 scriptures that just mentioned the eagles. You know, that's a good one right there. And then different ones that said fowl of the air was like 75, 76. But one thing that I concluded as I was looking through the Bible and counting and numbering things and seeing what the Lord had said about the different birds, I realized that God is a bird watcher. He watches over his birds. He watches over his creation. He watches over us because we are his creation. And there's a lot to be learned about birds. If you go home and you Google birds after a while, y'all, and I want some of you to do it, because there was some YouTube things that I watched by myself, and there's some that me and Joey watched, and it's some of them is hilarious, but some of them is you learn so much, and you see how close they are to the way that humans act around with their children. So first I want to go to Matthew 6:25 and 26. I'm going to read that first. And I'm reading this one from the King James Version, and some of the others will be a different version. But therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat, or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? 26 says, behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are you not much better than they are? Are you not much better than even the birds of the air? Now I want to stop here for just a minute, because I wrote something down this morning, and I just want to bring this out real quick before we get into about the birds and flying without falling. Worry. When I was reading that scripture, I saw the word worry. Worry has an ill effect on our bodies, y'all. It has a grave effect that we do not need to try to work or to worry. We need to get rid of worry. We try. I used to do it all the time. I used to worry myself sick. Now, I'm serious. I would get sick because I worried about different things that I had no control over. I had no control over. Only God had control over these things. So I had to give it to God. But here Jesus is telling us in this first scripture, the 25th scripture, said, don't worry. Don't worry about any of those things. Don't worry about the things that God has promised to supply for you. Don't worry about them. Number one, worry damages your health. Worry may disrupt your productivity. Worry may negatively affect the way that you treat others. Can I get an amen on that?
Amen.
We've all been there. We've all gotten upset and gotten really worried in our spirit and then snap at somebody or say something to somebody. It's not worth it, y'all. Worry may reduce your ability to trust in God. Because if you're worrying, we're really not trusting in God. Amen. Amen.
That's right.
Now, here's the difference between worry and genuine concern, because we can be concerned. People say, well, I'm just concerned, instead of worry. Worry immobilizes a person. It stops everything in your life. All you can think about is what's going on. All you can think about is what can I do to get rid of it. But concern moves us to action. Concern tells us, this is what I need for you. Do. Go and do this. Get something done, and then that way you won't have that worry. I don't know why I had to say that, but I had to say that this morning. So let's get back to our scriptures about the birds. To fly without falling. Look at the birds. The Lord said, look at the birds, Martha. That's what he always says when he says something to me. He always adds my name at the end of it. And I know that I better stop and listen to what he has to say and let him speak to me. Because when I hear my name, I know that it's the Lord calling. So he said, behold the fowls of the air. Look at the birds, Martha. Consider for just a moment the birds and how they fly without falling. You know, you can Google, you can go and look at different things, and you'll find out how you can see how that they fly without falling. The thing that I found is that they use their strong chest muscles to flap their wings. And as they flap, it gives them the thrust or the push that they need or the force that they need to move themselves through the air. Now, I'm seeing myself in this way. I'm seeing you in this way, that we have that force. We have to push sometimes, especially when everything is against us. And we just got to keep pushing. And we got to use that force that we need in us, that we know, that breastplate of righteousness that we can hold up, that shield of faith that we can have. We need those things. So I went and I watched a couple quite a few of the YouTube videos. How do birds fly? That's what I put in there. How do birds learn to fly? One said it like this. They said, it's a big day in the life of a bird when they learn how to fly. The mamas are there. They're encouraging them. You know, they're watching them. They're seeing what all's going on. They know that they've got to learn. Just like we all know that we have to teach our children how to walk, or, you know, help them learn to walk. We got to teach them how to eat the right things. We got to teach them all these things. Well, this is what the birds do. They watch. These mamas watch. And in some cases, the mamas even push them out of the nest. And I'm thinking, oh, man, what did she do that for? That's got to hurt. You know, I was just sitting there on edge at some of them, you know, and I'm thinking, oh, man, is that what we do? You know, all of us. It was amazing. But in some of the cases of the eagles, take the eagles for instance, there's about 3 months that the mama and the daddy both, they are feeding those babies. They are getting those babies prepared. You can watch them, and they're just bringing them food, and they'll even drop it into their mouth, you know, and they're just feeding them for those 3 months, making sure that they grow up. And they're going to grow, and they're growing their little wings. That's what's happening, is their wings are beginning to grow. And so after that 3 months, the mama flies out of the nest. She decides, okay, today's the day. I'm flying out of this nest. And when I fly out of this nest, I am coming back. I am coming back, and I'm coming back wild. She comes into that nest, and she's thrashing around. She's stirring up that nest, and she's doing all kinds of things. And then all of a sudden, one of those birds just falls out. And I'm sitting there. Mama flies down, and she flies up first, and she's watching all that's going on, and what that baby's thinking. That baby's going down, 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 down to the earth, down to the ground. It's going down. It's headed down, but Mama's watching. Mama's watching. God's watching. He might be pushing you. Oh, hallelujah. He might be pushing you out of the nest right now, but I'm going to tell you, he has. Oh, I'm telling you. And then out of all that commotion, as Mama is watching the baby, she just kind of like swoops down with her wings outspread. Them big old gigantic wings, I'm telling you, I pulled out of my house this morning. I don't have a clue whether it was an eagle or whether it was one of those vultures or whatever it is, but I pulled out of my subdivision this morning, and there was a bird up there all by itself. And I mean, it was flying, and the wingspread looked so wide. It looked as wide as this whole board right here. And I'm just sitting there at the end of Peter, or whichever one they are, they're just not sure what's going to happen. They just know they're falling, and they're trying to flap their little tiny wings, and they're just not sure what's going to take place. They see that ground way, 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 way down. One of them that me and Joe, I think it was the one me and Joe we watched, when those birds flew out, or when those birds were went out of the nest, it was like you looked way, way, way up, and they were way up there. How in the world? How in the world would Mama let that happen? How in the world would God let that happen to us? Just let us fall out of the nest. Oh, but He does. It is for our learning. It is for our learning. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I can just hear that Mama, just like I hear God saying, flap your wings, baby. Flap your wings, baby. Flap your wings. I need you to flap your wings. I pushed you out of the nest, but I need you to flap your wings. That's the way I was thinking it myself. You know, I'd be the Mama that would say, Colleen, flap your wings. Val, flap your wings. You know, that's what I'd be doing at that moment if I was the bird. I'm telling you. And then all of a sudden the bird will begin to flap. But He's not going nowhere. He's still going down. Still going down. There's still things happening. He's still hitting the side of the mountain. He's still going down the side of the mountain and trying his best to flap. But he don't never fly. But that Mama just swoops down and she grabs him back up. That's what Jesus does for us. That's what the Father will do for us when we get to almost to the ground and He sees that we haven't learned yet how to fly those wings. Then He just swoops down and He pulls us right back up. He holds on to us. He takes us back to the nest and He says, okay, we're going to start all over again tomorrow.
Yes. Glory.
Have you ever been through anything once, twice, three times, four times? You got almost to the bottom. Almost to the ground. And God just swooped you back up and He took you back to the nest and said, let's try this again tomorrow. Oh, Lord, I don't know about you. I don't know about you. But that just does something to me. Does something for me. That's exactly what God does for us. Exactly what He does for His children. Now, you know, we can teach our children. We can teach them how to survive. We can teach them how to fly out in this world. We can teach them all kinds of things. We can teach them to respect others. We can teach them to trust others. All these things, the same thing that God teaches us. We can teach them to discipline themselves, to get up in the mornings and go to school, or when they get old enough to get a job, to get up in the morning and go to their job. Be honest. You know, we can teach all of these things. We can teach them how to be wise with their money. Like Joey said last week, we can show them all of these things. But I'm going to tell you the most important thing that you don't ever want to leave out. Never, ever want to leave out. And I don't care if it's children or anybody on the face of this earth. You want to show them the way to Jesus. You want to show them the pathway to Jesus. You want to make sure, yes, absolutely, make sure that they plan for their future. Make sure that they, you know, if they got a job that offers 401k or 403b like I got, you, make sure that they say, okay, I'm going to give a little in this every month or every week, and I'm going to make sure that I have something at the end. And, you know, and we gotta trust that we can teach them these things. But planning for eternity. If you don't ever teach them anything else, teach them to plan for eternity. Because that is the most important thing. That is the reason Jesus came to teach us all of these things. Yes, He did. But He died on the cross for us. And we are to be out there telling people. Romans 6:23 in the NLT, so the New Living Translation, says, for the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Teach our children that the free gift, that you have a free gift. You can get this free gift. All you've got to do is say, Lord, come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. It is as easy as that. Tell them that. Romans 10, 9:10, and then verse 13 says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart, those are the two things that we have to do, just confess that he is Lord, believe it in our hearts that God raised him from the dead, then you're saved. For it is by believing in your heart that you are made right with God. And it is by confessing with your mouth that you are saved. Believe it in your heart, confess it with your mouth. That's the way we get saved. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. If you do anything in this life, teach people the way to the Lord. Show them the way of the Lord. These are the only two scriptures really you need. And John 3:16, telling you, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Have everlasting life. We are going to live somewhere. When we leave this earth, we are all going to live somewhere. Make sure that everybody that you come in contact with knows that there is a heaven to gain and there is a hell to shun. Make sure that they know that. Oh, just as we read in our text in Matthew 6, God is our protector, and he protects his creation. God said, look at the birds. Look at the birds. I take care of them. And how much more will I take care of you? How much more will I take care of you because you are my own children? Yes, that is my creation, but you are my children, and I will take care of you. Exodus 19:4 tells us, you have seen what I did unto the Egyptians and how I bear on you angels' wings, bear you up on angels' wings and brought you unto myself. See, that's what the Lord does. Just like I said a while ago, he will bear us up on angel wings or on eagle wings, and he will hold us. He will bring us to himself. God is protective of his children. He's very protective of his children. The eagles, when you look at them, when you watch them on YouTube, you will see how protective those eagles are for their own children also. But there's some birds, not all birds, are protective like the eagles. There are some birds that I found, and it was like, oh man, they push and they prod and they just kick you out. They just kick you out of the nest. And Joey and I watched one where the birds were on the edge of the nest. They were sitting right there on the edge of the nest, and when they went out, you know, it's just like one right after the other. They were just going out. They just went out. Mama was outside, I believe, wasn't she? And she was just watching them here. And so they as they began to fall out of the nest, they were tumbling over and over and over. They were tumbling on the side of the mountain. Some of them, they would get up there, they would come down, and then you'd think, oh, they're going to fly. Oh, they're going to do it. It's going to happen. And then all of a sudden, they'd hit the side of the mountain. I mean, they hit hard. They hit that side of the mountain hard, constantly, just down, down, down. You know, you've seen people where they've failed, and they're just tumbling, 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 and they're hitting everything that's coming, rocks and everything. That's what these birds were doing. They were just hitting. And you were thinking, oh, man, they didn't make it. They didn't make it. This one's not going to make it. This one just, there's no way. Do you see yourself in that? Sometimes I ain't going to make it, Lord. I can't do it, Lord. I'm getting hit on every side. Every rock that can come up against me, everything that can come up against me, I'm getting hit on every side. Do you feel that way sometimes? That's the way I think this bird was feeling that I was watching, or these little birds. There was quite a few of them. But where was Mama? Mama was flying high. She was watching them. She wasn't going down there to help them. Sometimes God won't come and help. He'll just stand and watch because there's a lesson to be learned. When I hear him say, learn a lesson, Martha, I know that I'm about to learn a lesson. And sometimes he just has to stand there and watch me, and he has to wait. Now, do we not do our children that way? Do we not do others that way when we see that they're going through something? And there are sometimes, y'all, I will tell you that my heart aches like I have never felt before for some of you, because I know that you are going through things and there is not a thing that I can do except pray. That's the way I feel sometimes. And I feel like that's the way God feels. He says, they got to learn. And so I'm just going to help them. I'm just going to watch them. Now, if anything came up, and I mean, if you were going to get hurt really, really bad, he would send his angels to give charge over you to keep you in all of your ways, lest you dash your foot against a stone. But here these little birds were. Mama swoops down into the ravine, and she just stands there. She just looking like, okay, where y'all at? There was six of you. Where are you? And here comes some of them. And here comes some of them. And then one would come up, and the other one would come up, and the other one would come up. And then that one that I saw fall, never get up. I thought, oh, he's gone. No. He got up, and he walked on with the mama. He trotted on. Now, there was one that got lost in the water, but I'm sure he'd come along somewhere along the way and got out of the water. But I'm telling you, if they made it, this is how mama felt. If they made it, they made it. And if they didn't, they didn't. If they made it, did you hear that one? If they made it, they made it. And if they didn't, they didn't. But that's not the way God feels about us. He wants us. He's right there, and he's saying, come on, I know you can do this. I know you can do this. Fly, baby, fly. That's what he wants us to do, is fly, to learn to fly. When you've been knocked down so much, knocked down to the foot of the mountain like that little bird was that I saw, when you've been, feel like that you've been beaten down, because that little bird, before he got up, I thought, he's gone. He is beaten all to pieces by those rocks on the mountain. He couldn't get a grasp. He couldn't get a hold. He couldn't fly. He couldn't make himself fly. Sometimes we feel like that. Sometimes that's us. We've all failed at flying sometimes. We've all failed. But that's when we just raise our hands, just like he did. He just raised his little head back up once he got, fell to the very bottom of the ravine. He just laid there for a minute. We can lay there. We can say, help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. I can't go no farther. I can't get up. I've done been beat down. All these rocks have just got the best of me today. All this side of the mountain has just got me. And then we can just raise our hands, lift up our head, and shout. Shout! Let me tell you some words to shout, okay? Romans 8:37 says, nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us and gave himself for us. We are more than conquerors. No matter what went on, no matter what happened, when he fell on that desk, no matter what it took to get down to the bottom of the ground, no matter what it is, he is still a conqueror because he got up and he went on his way. Oh, I'm telling you, God is good. 1 Corinthians 15:57 says, oh, give thanks. Oh, thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. He got the victory. He might not have thought he was going to have the victory in the end, but he got the victory in the end. He got himself back up and he walked on. He moved on. I'm telling you, God is good to us. 1 John 5:4 says, for everyone who has been born of God overcomes the world. Oh, did you hear that? Everyone who has been born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world. Our faith. Our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Our faith to hold on to God the Father. Oh, Jesus, God just wants his children to fly without falling. He wants us to learn to fly without falling. and he gives us everything we need in life to survive without falling. But it's up to us. It's up to us. Whatever we do, it's up to us to learn to flap those wings and to keep flapping even though we feel like we're falling, but to keep flapping until we get up and the wings start moving and they get bigger and they get bigger and they get bigger, and then we can go forward more and more and more in God. Whew, God is good. 2 Peter 1 and 3 says, He has given us all things. He, God, has given us all things that pertain unto life and godliness. Everything, every resource, everything we need to survive, God, it says it right here, has given it to us. I haven't seen that scripture. I mean, I read the Bible through every year, but I have not looked, I guess you could say. You have to, sometimes they just illuminate themselves. And that one illuminated itself this week. 2 Peter 1 and 3, He has given all things. And this is just a part of it. There's a whole scripture there. But I took the part out that I felt like He was speaking to us. He has given us all things that pertain unto life and godliness. Everything we need to survive. Everything. The Lord has laid it out for us. I mean, it is laid out there for us. All we got to do is get it. Just like the eagle that waits patiently. God is waiting patiently on us to move. He says, it's right there. It's right there. It's right there. It's right there in front of you. I just need for you to move. I just need for you to take it. You know, the gifts are out there. But sometimes the giver wants you to hand your hand out and say, okay, I'll take it. You know? If you never held your hand out, would you get the gift? If you never said anything like thank you, how would that giver feel? You know, got to think about it that way sometimes. Isaiah 30 and 18, this is the Message Bible. I love the way this is put. It says, God's not finished. He's not finished. He's just waiting around to be gracious to you. He's just waiting around to be gracious to us. Oh, I tell you, that's good. He's gathering strength to show mercy to you. God takes the time. Oh, listen to this. God takes the time to do everything right. Everything that He does, He's going to do it right. Now, I can hear it because I said it in my own spirit the day that I read this, the Thursday or Friday, whichever day it was. I remember thinking, you do everything right, Lord, but what about all these things that are wrong or that seem to be wrong in my life, Lord? And He says, those are just things where I had to push you out of the nest. You're learning, Martha. You're learning. And what good would it do for us if God didn't teach us? He expects us as parents to teach our children things. So why would we not expect the same out of our Father? That's my question to you today. If you're going through something really hard, it's for your learning. Learn it. Learn it. Learn. Say, Lord, show me what you want me to learn in this. Let me know what you want me to learn. I used to say that. Sister Nancy, I used to say that so many times. I'd say, Lord, what do I need to learn out of this? Because I'm ready to get through it. I'm ready to get it over with. I'm tired of going through this, Lord. And then He'd show me something else. And then I would just begin to study it out and then realize, oh, thank you, Lord. And now, today, and I'm sure that all of you that are as old as I am or older, you can say, yeah, the things that the Lord taught me back then is for right now. For right now. Right this very moment. Lena, right now. All those things that we learned back in Sunday school, they're for right now. All those times that we were drugged to church, Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, Friday night, Saturday night, we went all the time. Because we had youth meetings, we had youth choir practice, we had all kinds of stuff, and we were always in church. I've told y'all before, my pastor's wife, Janie, before before she passed away. She was my confidant. And she would call me on the phone, because we didn't have cell phones back then. She'd call me on the phone would ring in the house. I'd run to the phone and pick it up, and she'd say, "Have gun, we'll travel." I said, "Okay, let me get dressed. I'll be there in a minute." We knew we were going to the church. I knew I was going to the church. Most all the time, I was going to the church. And what would I be doing? I would be on my feet, on my knees, hands and knees, and I'd be scrubbing floors. She liked clean floors in the back. You remember those floors? Oh, they were so irritating. But I learned a lesson. I learned back then that if she had not taught me how to do that and how to take care of a church building, I wouldn't know how today. But she taught me how. So whatever you're going through, whatever is happening to you right now, and you're thinking, "I don't like this. I can't take it anymore. I can't do this anymore." Just remember that you're going to use it one day. If you just give God the chance. Oh, if you just give God the chance, Lord, He will use everything to His glory and
Amen.
To His honor. That's going on in your life right now, Tiffany. He's everything. All your children, all of their problems, He would use it to His glory and to His honor. In the name of Jesus. I believe it. I believe it without a doubt. I believe it. Isaiah 30 and 21. "And if you leave God's path and go astray, you will hear a voice behind you saying, 'No.'" And I think I quoted that to somebody a while ago. "No, this is the way. Walk you in it. Walk you in it." See, the Lord will open up your eyes, and He will let you see things, and He will open up your heart, and He will allow you to hear things, and especially His voice. But His voice, sometimes, most of the time, I'll be honest with you, I've only heard the Lord speak loud. And like so loud to get my attention that my heart done like this one time. I only heard it one time. But it was to get my attention, because I was paying Him no attention at that moment. And He needed for me to pay Him attention so that I would not get hurt. And that's the only time I remember. But all the other times, He comes in that still, small voice. And sometimes we just have to get still. And yes, we will. We will have that time where God will just bring us into that place where we get so still. We'll just have to wait on Him. Those are the hardest times for the flesh. It's the hardest times to get in those places where God says, "Shh. Shh. I don't want you to say a word. I just want you to sit with me." I learned how to do that. It took me a couple of years. Brother Joey, it took me a couple of years to learn when the Lord would say, "Shh, I just need you to sit and be with me." So I didn't understand that. I had never been taught that I could just sit in the presence of God. But I'm telling you this morning, you can just sit in the presence of God, and you don't have to say a word, because He knows what your heart's saying. He knows what your mind's thinking. And He knows what your tears are feeling. He knows that. He knows it. I've come to the knowledge of learning or going over these YouTube things and watching how the birds fly and how they learn to fly and how the mamas and the daddies do them. I've learned. I've come to the knowledge, I think, that the Lord just wants His children to fly without falling. He just wants His children to fly without falling. And if we do, He will swoop down and pick you right back up. And you'll start all over again. When you feel like you just can't go any further, when you feel like you're at the end of everything, somebody said that yesterday. But when you feel like you're there, all you got to do is just look up. Because those little birds, all I could see when they were trying to fly is they were looking up. They were looking up. We got to look up, people. We got to look up to the Lord Jesus Christ. That's where he's at. He's right there on his throne and he's looking at us. And we just got to look up at him and say, Father, I feel like I'm falling and I don't know what to do. And then he will pick you up. And then you can start all over if you need to.